In this tutorial, I'm going to show you one of my favorite programs for checking color contrast. It's called Color Contrast Analyzer by the Pacillo Group. So if you type in Color Contrast Analyzer in Google search, you should come to this page, color spelled C-O-L-O-U-R. And this program is free. If you scroll down, you'll see a button to download it for Windows or Mac. Once you click on the Windows one, you'll be taken to a screen where you can save the executable to your downloads folder. I already have it installed. So once it's installed, you can access it from your Windows Start, or if you have it in your system tray, you can simply click the button for it and it'll pop up on top of the web browser that you're in. So I want to check my institution's homepage because I know that it has some color contrast issues on it. So it's a good one to use as an example. So what's so nice about Color Contrast Analyzer, if you're a graphic designer and you work with Photoshop, this has an eyedropper tool that has similar functionality to the one in Photoshop. Once you click it, you can hover over text on the page and click on the foreground color, text color, and then you can click the second eyedropper and sample your background color. And you'll see the colors represented in hexadecimal code here at the top, but you can also toggle between red, green, blue, the hue, saturation, and lightness, and the hue, saturation, value options. So this gives you the color in different formats for you to work with the values in different formats. So if you're working with Microsoft Office, you'll want to choose the RGB values. But if you find a color that has an issue, like this light gray that's been used for this submenu here at the top, I can see at the bottom here that it fails for regular text size as well as large text size. It's only 2.8:1 contrast ratio. I need to get it up to 4.5:1 for regular text or 3:1 for larger text size. So what I can do is take this lightness slider and inch it down until I see it comes in and passes for, I would like it to pass for regular text. So I'll keep inching down. And then when it comes in, I can look at this value at the top and you can go to your web development program. I'm going to open developer tools here. I'm gonna inspect this element by right-clicking on it. And then if I right click in the developer panel, I can edit as HTML. If I just go into this element here and add some inline styling for this value, color, pound, 737373, and then close this panel, I can see the change happen right here on the page, how I can correct this color, and it's not that far off from the original color that was selected. If you want to copy these values, you can go to Edit, Copy Results. You can open up a Word document. And then paste those results in. So perhaps you would put some header on this, like secondary navigation to meet the web content accessibility guidelines for color contrast. And then you can share this document with other designers at your institution to improve the accessibility of your website. So this program is keyboard accessible. If you go up to the color contrast menu here and go to preferences, you'll see that there are shortcut keys for picking the foreground and the background color. So F4 and F12 activates this eyedropper tool. So if I click F4 on my keyboard, you can see it's activated the eyedropper for foreground color. And I'm using my arrow keys to get to where I need to be. Let's say I want to pick white text, and then I want to click on F12 on my keyboard. Oops, didn't do it. Let's see. I can also tab through these values here until I get to it, but F12 should have selected this. I hit enter, and then I can arrow up to the background color that I want to select and click enter. And there I have my values, and I see that this is a problem too. So this has the ability to show you what the foreground color against the background looks like for people with various color blindnesses. So here at the top is what somebody with monochromacy would see. They don't sense color with their eyes. You can see the contrast ratio is 2.4 to 1. And then somebody that has no sensitivity to red, no sensitivity to green, and no sensitivity to blue, also low red, low green, and low blue sensitivity in their eyes. So this is helpful too. For the second part of this tutorial, I'd like to show you how to use Color Contrast Analyzer to change a color that's too light within a document. So here I have a Word file where my second heading level is this lighter green color, this one here for secondary navigation. And I sampled it with the eyedropper tool. And I can see down here at the bottom that it fails for regular text as well as large text. It's only 2.2 to 1 contrast ratio. I can make sure I'm on the hue, saturation, and lightness button, and then drag the lightness slider downward until I see that it passes for regular text. Okay, so this value right here would be okay to use for changing the color. So let me copy that to my clipboard. When I go to my Word document, this is a heading level 2, and I actually have this color set within heading level 2. So if I right click on it and select modify, I can go to the color, select more colors, and then paste in that hexadecimal code for the darker green and click OK. Click OK here. And it changes the color. So you're probably thinking what I'm thinking, that it doesn't look so great. It's not so nice. In this case, I would simply use the same color that I used for my heading level 1, which is 006A4D. That's the university green where I work, and that actually works fine for the color contrast ratio. You can see here it passes for regular text as well as large text. But, I mean, that is one way you can do it. You could also play around with RGB values for that lighter green to see if you could find something you like. Or you can adjust the values in Word for the heading 2 again. Go to modify. And under the color picker, choose more colors. If you go to the standard wheel, I would try to stick with one of these darker ones from the outside. You could simply pick one that you like, click OK, click OK again, and take the eyedropper tool, resample that color, and look at the bottom and see that it passes. Then you're okay. So this is Color Contrast Analyzer.